नमस्कार, तुमकां सगळ्यांक पेंट ब्रश ह्या कार्यावळीक येवकार हांव नागेश राव सरदेसाय. आमी आसात आयसीजीन इंटरनॅशनल सेंटर गोंय दोना पावला आशिल्ल्या कल्चरल सेंटरान. हांगा डिफरंट नांवाचें एक एग्जिबिशन इम्पॅक्ट ह्या कंपनीन घाल्लें आसा. इम्पॅक्टाची मेंबर्स लविना, मिलिशा आनी रोवन हे तिगूय जाणांनी मेळून हें एग्जिबिशन घाल्लें आसा. हातूंत अनेक आर्टिस्ट आसात, चडशे भायले, थोडे गोंयकार अशें मेळून एग्जिबिशन अनेक तरेच्यो स्टायल्स हांगा आसात. आलेक्स रॉड्रिगीस हो एक आर्टिस्ट आसा, ताजे कडेन उलोवया, ताजी पेंटिंगां पयलीं पळोवया आनी नंतर आमी मिलिशा आनी रोवन हांचे कडेन उलोवया. आयसीजीन डिफरंट नांवाच्या एग्जिबिशनान आलेक्स रॉड्रिग्स हो मूळ गोंयचो पूण रावता मुंबय ह्या आर्टिस्टाचें वर्क आसा. ताच्या बरोबर अनेक आनीक आर्टिस्टाचें वर्क आसा पूण आमच्या बरोबर आसा आलेक्स रॉड्रिग्स, ताजे कडेन उलोवया. आलेक्स, वेलकम टू द शो. टॅल मी अबावट दीस होल शो अँड युअर वर्क.
वेल, द शो इज कॉल्ड डिफरंट. इट्स बेसिकली कॉल्ड डिफरंट बिकॉज ऑफ द कायंड ऑफ वर्क्स वी हॅव हियर. It's a group show, so we have different artists. We've got different kind of artifacts. We've got paintings, we've got kurtas, we've got t-shirts for the summers, art in a bottle, all kinds of works. Besides that, we've got different genres of paintings. We've got realism, we've got surrealism, we've got impressionism, we've got religious works, we've got some abstracts, watercolors. So that's why the name apt renamed. It's called different.
And your works are also shown here, displayed here. Tell us something more about your work.
Okay. My works, basically I'm a finger painting artist, one of its kind. I paint with the fingers and bare hands. I don't use a brush. And the paintings displayed over here are all Christ's or religious works inspired from the Bible. Since it's Goa, I prefer to use themes either linked with Jesus Christ or the Bible. People connect more to it, and in the form of art, it's appreciated more. Now, when I paint, I don't use a brush at all. It's just fingers, nails, bare hands. Hence, the appreciation is a lot more by the viewer, by the buyer, because they've seen a lot of good works over the years. But then when there's a uniqueness to it, painted bare hands, without a brush, without a palette knife, the appreciation is a lot more, they value it more. So you'll see a lot of my works, a lot of colorful works, but every detailed work, everything is just bare hands.
You are a self-taught artist. You have not been trained as such academically to paint. Why did you think of getting into art? You are a chemistry graduate, as far as I know. So how did this shift from chemistry with chemicals to chemistry with paint begin?
Like most people say, it's a long story. I wouldn't say that. It's a very short, brief story, actually. While schooling, I was a good student, and I usually followed my elder sister, who is a brighter student than I am. She went ahead and got into the stream of science and graduated, majored in chemistry. So I didn't look left, I didn't look right, I just went straight for chemistry. I just needed to graduate. I knew I was not intending to do anything with science. I always knew I'd get into art or dancing. Those are my two fortes. So that's it, I graduated. I started teaching dancing, I've been dancing all along, and then I also wanted to get art into the picture somehow. So I started doing art, started painting, and one of my clients was an art dealer, and she said, you paint those with your fingers, wow. She said, can we sell those? And I said, yeah, feel free to sell them. And that's how the journey began. Being a chemistry student, I think I get into the details of colors. I make sure I know what kind of colors I'm using, what kind of chemicals, whether they're strong, they're ones that could cause cancer, toxic, non-toxic. I pay a lot of attention to that because I gotta take care of these hands because I paint with my fingers. And yeah, so that's how it is.
How did this love with brush, away from chemistry with brush, as I said, chemistry with paint began? In the sense, you did your graduation in chemistry. You didn't think of doing fine arts, you didn't think of academically getting trained.
Okay, as a kid, I've always been painting. My journey started actually as maybe a 2 or 3 year old kid, where I used to scribble on the walls, and a lot of it. And my parents, instead of yelling or shouting at me and stopping me, they always showed me pictures in the scribblings. They said, that thing looks like a horse, or that looks like a man. And I was obviously very inspired and encouraged to go ahead and do more. So I scribbled a little more, and then they gave me...
They didn't stop you from doing that?
They did not. They always said, see, it looks like something. And then I was more encouraged, and then they got me papers, books, and then I just kept painting, sketching more and more and more. And from that time, even in school, even being a bright student, I never wanted to do anything with studies. I just studied and graduated because one has to be educated. And always knew I was going to do something with art or dancing. Something creative is what I knew I was going to do. So yeah, over the years growing up, I was always encouraged by parents, by my family, my sisters. They said, oh, that painting's really nice, you should try doing this, you should try doing that, get a little better on this. So growing up, I can say I was molded into being an artist in a way. And the day I passed out, I knew I didn't want to get any formal training in art, because I've been a bit of a stubborn child. I never wanted to learn anything when I could do it already. And I always thought that if you go to an art school, you're taught a certain way, you're shown a certain path, you practice hours a day to do a portrait, and you may be a master at it, but then you do it in a certain way. You do landscapes, you do it in a certain way because you're taught how to. So I never wanted to do that. I wanted creativity to come from inside. When I could already do it, I didn't want to learn how to do it. I mean, it's imbibed, it's in you, it's in your blood. So I just thought I'd do it my way. Like Frank Sinatra said, I do it my way.
Even then, let me ask you as to who was your inspiration? Because sometimes your mother is your inspiration, sometimes your neighbor, your drawing teacher, somebody or the other, because you didn't have art in your family, I believe. So how did that materialize?
Well, I'd say my family is my main inspiration to start with, number one, because I had a very nice, loving family. We celebrated every festival, and it was done full on. Like, for example, to give you an example, Easter, we painted eggs on Easter. We boiled eggs and then we painted on them. My mum painted eggs, my dad painted eggs, my sisters did it, and they were all good at it. And of course, so you're encouraged to paint there as well. So I think that's the upbringing has kind of, like I said, it's molded me into an artist. So painting Easter eggs, creating, making crepes for Christmas, preparing Christmas cards. There was art everywhere. So although I don't have an arty name in the family, everybody had a leaning towards creativity. And I guess that's where I get it from. And having lost my dad very early on in life, my mom and my sisters, I grew up with three women in the house. So I paint a lot of women in every form, every different form, but I just tend to paint a lot of ladies. And I think that's where my inspiration comes from. Apart from that, I've been brought up as a Catholic child, a lot of church, reading the Bible, things like that. And so Christ has been a big, strong influence, including stories from the Bible. So those two things have inspired me much. Speaking of any outside influence, I think I've been a fan of Leonardo da Vinci and Michelangelo, just two artists whom I probably could think of that would influence me in the slightest way. And so, yeah, being the old masters, the kind of works that they did, the beauty that they created, has always inspired me a lot.
And how did this love for dance, and then you're teaching dance as well, so tell us something about that.
Well, like I've been painting as a kid, since I was a kid and always did. Similarly, dancing was there in the family because every birthday party, every Christmas party, every wedding we went to, you know, you're always dancing as a Catholic kid. and I think it was imbibed. I was always born to dance. I danced a lot. My parents encouraged me again. I've had no formal training, but at the age of 16, where I was already a full-fledged dancer, I went for one of these auditions for a dance teacher's position. It was at one of the first ballroom in Latin American dance class in India. It's in Bombay. It was called JJ Rodrigues. I don't know what it's called now. And I got through out of 52 people. Mm-hmm. And that's where my polishing really happened for teaching. And taught there for about 6 months. And honestly, I got a little bored with the old style ballroom and I had to do something a little fast paced. So I started teaching on my own. I skipped from the traditional 1-2-3s and I skipped a step and I went on to like street jiving and stuff. And manipulated it a bit, and I still teach dance until this day. It's been I've always been a dancer more than a teacher, to be very honest. I used to perform when I was in the 10th grade. I performed over a few cities in India, and I think all the performing, all the dancing just made me more of a dancer than anything else before I was an artist. And yeah, so I've been teaching dancing since I was 16 and just never looked back. That has been like my main job. In fact, because of which another job came up, which I should tell you is very interesting. As a dancer, I would do a lot of aerial lifts with your partners, you know, with the Latin American moves in the ballroom. And I had heavier partners. I used to be a scrawny boy, just 60 kilos. And so I would end up with a lot of backache and stuff with lifting really heavy partners. So I got into working out. Someone told me about a fitness course where I could study about health and fitness management, nutrition. I went and did a diploma in that. So today I'm a...
That led to your fitness?
Yeah, so I'm a certified fitness trainer and nutritionist. So teaching dancing and personal training people for fitness are the two things that I do whenever I have to fall back on a job, when I want to take a break from painting or when the markets have dipped with the art. So yeah, these three things are... Two things, I'd say dancing and art is my life and fitness keeps my life going.
How is your connection to Goa and how frequently do you come to Goa? Because I believe you stay in Goa for half the year. How is that?
That's true. I stay in Goa for about half the year. I actually studied and grew up in Bombay. But every possible chance, every holiday we got, we came down to Goa, obviously. My dad's from Goa. We're originally from Margao. Now we moved down to a quieter, peaceful place called Kunkolam, where I can do a lot of painting for myself. I still spend about 6 months every year in Bombay because Bombay is where I have to be for exhibitions, get a lot of work done out there. Goa for me is mainly 6 months of hardcore painting where I just paint. So yeah, I spend about 5 to 6 months in Goa every year. But the main work happens in Bombay. Then I try to do a lot of work in Goa with the exhibitions.
And tell me about the whole exhibition that you have set up. I believe you are the one who has picked up all these artists, selected them and brought them here. You are part of the organizing team. Why did you think of selecting these artists? How, on what basis did you select? And do you think this whole show that you have set up is successful?
Yeah, I've been part of the organizing team in terms of I've selected the artists, I've selected the works and then brought them down here to the exhibition. Mainly the artists, I know a lot of them. I've worked with them before, we've exhibited together before, so I know most of them personally. A few of them have been referred by the other artists, and hence after looking at their works, after looking at their resumes, knowing what they've done, we've included people and brought them here.